Hey, welcome to Graphic Apostle Television GPTV. It's a new week of comics that in my hands is one of those releases. It's Child Star, published by First Second, and written and art by Box Brown. And it's good. It's really, really good. It's a graphic novel. I don't even know how to describe it. I'm going to do my best, and I'm going to do it a really roundabout way. So one of my favorite Simpsons episode was the Behind the Laughter episode, where they went and did kind of like a behind the music for The Simpsons. And of course, there was the whole thing of like, they were giving Bart and Lisa anti-growth hormones to keep them children, and like, the parents were stealing money, or Homer and Marge were stealing money from them, and like, just completely out there, like, every over-the-top stereotype that we heard of tragic stories about child actors. Well, that's what Child Star is in a nutshell. So it follows a child star named Owen Eugene, who became like the biggest thing in America, and it follows his rise and fall, his career, and of course all the tragedy that has to deal with it. It is like every stereotype that you can imagine, and if you grew up watching especially 80s shows, you will absolutely love this graphic novel. Like, it's got references to Punky Brewster and Different Strokes, and it's like everything's in there. I mean, they even have, so Punky Brewster, one of the episodes that always stands out to me is the fridge episode where they go play hide and seek, and it was supposed to be like a lesson that you're supposed to take the doors off the fridge because otherwise the kids will suffocate. Like, that's literally in here. The whole thing is just it's funny is that it's both a send up and like a love letter to all of that. I mean, it's just over the top, every horrible thing that you can imagine. I mean, for the most part, imagine like every stereotype of 80s sitcoms, of all the, you know, after school specials and clear propaganda and money they were taking from the government to do certain storylines. Like, it's all touched upon, the horrible parents, the contentious stuff behind the scenes, like the closeted actor, like it is all here. And it just, it's entertaining. Like, as someone who grew up watching those shows, I loved it. Like, I really, really like this graphic novel. You know, it's not about a real person, which would, you know, for some reason, it was funny if this all happened to a real person, it would be super tragic and depressing graphic novel. But because it's an imaginary character, it feels more like a send-up and kind of an homage and love letter to just, I don't want to say absurdity, but just all the crazy stories we've heard of 80s child stars. So, you know, if you're like me, you grew up in the 80s and watched those shows and can think of all those, like, horror stories and also the amazingness that is those television shows and episodes, you're gonna love this graphic novel. Like, this is one that is absolutely for, like, the 40-year-old, 50-year-old set. Which is really interesting. Like, I can nail the audience. And this is Gen X, the graphic novel is the best way of putting it. Like, the only thing that's missing is a whole 90s segment and grunge. Like, that's like the thing that's seriously missing is going through the 90s. Like, it's a fascinating graphic novel and really entertaining. Absolutely loved it. And it's, you know, it's got Box Brown's art style, which you might like or dislike. Like, I like it. It's a kind of a cartoony style. As you see here, the coloring is minimal. It's just black, white, red, gray. You know, nothing too fancy. And I think the minimal design of it all really helps pay off. Kind of going through stuff. And more entertaining is, like, every so often it breaks things up and takes you through actual episodes and plays out scenes. It's just, this is fantastic. You know, it's $19.99, out now in comic shops and bookstores. Go support your comic shop. I highly recommend it. Like, as someone who grew up during this, the time period that this graphic novel took place, like, this is awesome. Like, this is kind of my childhood in a nutshell. Like, all those memories I've got, all those things I grew up watching and dealt with afterwards is all kind of condensed in one graphic novel. Awesome, awesome, awesome stuff. I absolutely love it. Go check it out now. As I said, it's in comic shops. Go support your local comic shop. There is a link beneath this video. There are affiliate links, so you can go and purchase through that and support there's some comic shops there, but you also support us a little bit, but really go support your comic shop first and foremost. There is a link where you can also put in your zip code. It'll tell the shops near you, but no shop, no problem. We do have those affiliate links. Speaking of support, I want to thank First Second for hooking us up with this review copy. We appreciate it, and thank you for watching. Absolutely love this. This is, like, right up our alley. Box Brown knocks it out of the park yet again. This is a creator whose name is on stuff. Like, you're just... it's guaranteed to be good. So, yeah, I want to thank First Second. I want to thank you. If you're into graphic novels, if you're into comic books, check us out every single day at graphicpolicy.com. We're on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, Tumblr, all at Graphic Policy, keeping it nice and consistent. So until next time, keep reading those comics and keep a geeky. Hey, thanks for watching the previous video from Graphic Policy Television. Just by watching, you help support our site. Thank you so much. Now, if you're watching these videos, you probably care about geeky things like movies, television, comic books, toys, games, video games, you name it. You can go and subscribe right now to our YouTube channel to stay in touch and catch all the new videos, or check out our website at graphicpolicy.com. There's a nice link on this end of the video. But as always, thank you for watching. Keep on rocking and keep it geeky.